Hi, my name is Emma Sage from the Coffee Quality Institute, and today we are going to be talking about coffee pests, which is otherwise known as the creepy crawly lecture. The first group of bugs is the wood stem and twig boring beetles. This is a bunch of different species of small beetles that are really prevalent in Africa and Asia in particular. They can be very destructive. They include twig borers, black borers, yellow and white borers. How they work is they tunnel into the wood, into the stem or the bark of the coffee tree, and they damage the xylem and phloem of the tree, which are the tissues that transport water and nutrients around the tree. And they lay eggs in there, which leads to more beetles, which leads to even more damage. Controlling the stem borer or any type of wood borer is very challenging. A lot of it is just preventative. You can see some pictures here showing the type of damage that these borers do to the coffee tree. They kill the trees, essentially. In certain areas, it's been found that less borer damage occurs in shade conditions or higher altitude, but basically the only option is to try and keep trees healthy and remove the unhealthy trees because they're more susceptible to these beetles. If a plant is infected, basically the only choice is to completely remove and burn the affected trees to eradicate the pest. There's really no effective chemical or biological control, and there's been a lot of research on this, but the wood and stem borers are just very destructive. Another borer that we know, the coffee berry borer, is also a very destructive little beetle. It's very small and believed to be endemic to Central Africa, and now it's growing in all types of coffee regions. The symptoms that we can see is that the fruit starts to drop, and you can identify a small hole on the fruit where that beetle has entered. There are also physical damage to the seeds that you can see. It is insect damage as a defect, and it can result in a loss of quality and production. More about the borer, because it is so important. It matures relatively quickly, and the females lay up to 300 eggs, so they're very productive. The berry borers do have a few natural enemies, including certain species of fungi, which have been utilized and are being utilized for biological control. Another important coffee bug is the Entestia bug. I'm including this despite the fact that the bug itself maybe is not directly responsible for the damaged coffee, but it is a small shield or stink bug, and it can damage coffee because it kind of bores into the plant and the fruit. But why it is infamous is because it is believed to spread the bacteria responsible for the potato taste defect, which is prevalent in the Great Lakes region in Africa. And the certain bacteria produces a compound which smells like green potatoes. It is a very potent compound, and it can be detected at very low concentrations. So it's a big challenge. Control of the Entestia bug is mostly done manually, with traps or just manually removing the bugs. Pruning and giving more air space, sort of in between the branches, has been reported to decrease the prevalence of the bug. The bug tends to like very dense foliage. There are also reports that certain powders and oils are effective to help reduce the incidence of these bugs. Again, the bug itself, maybe it's just a vehicle for the actual problem, which is a bacteria, but I included it here because it's a very infamous coffee bug at this point. Next, we have leaf miners. Leaf miners are a moth. You don't usually notice them as a moth, you notice them as a little larva, which is shown here, and the damage that they do to coffee leaves, which is usually pretty minor, but if there's a big infestation, it can be damaging to the plant. These type of moths are endemic to Africa, and they were identified in Brazil very early in the 1850s. Again, you can see an example of some leaf damage here, but there are these little tunnels that are left, necrosis or browning of the leaves, and if the leaf is damaged, it reduces its photosynthetic capacity, and therefore can be responsible for a loss of productivity. Nematodes are a bunch of different small worms. They get into the roots of coffee plants and cause destruction. And this shows up as sort of galls on the roots. There's a picture here on the left. Basically, the roots are damaged and the plant is starved of water and nutrients. They can be very damaging. In fact, the coffee industry has come up with a bit of a fix for nematodes in certain regions where they're very prevalent, where Arabica roots are actually removed from coffee seedlings and Robusta roots, which are hardier, are grafted on. And in this way, in regions where nematodes are a big problem, the hardier roots, if you will, from Robusta are more resistant to the nematode damage. Green scale is scientifically really gross. Green scale bugs are very small, sort of flat bugs. You can see them here on a coffee stem. Scale bugs are very productive. They lay lots and lots of eggs, which then hatch within hours. And they create this sticky film on the plant leaves. And this can result in what we call sooty mold. And in this picture on the right, you can see some kind of black film on the coffee leaves. And that's the sooty mold. This sticky film can also attract other insects like ants. And then the ants serve to spread the scale bugs all around. So it's pretty bad cycle to be in, and a plant with this kind of an infestation and also the sooty mold can really lose productivity. Some other bugs include mealybugs and weevils. Mealybugs also kind of look like the scale bugs, and they can lead to the sooty mold. And then the weevils are also pretty destructive. They lay eggs in coffee pulp, and then the larvae pupate in the drying coffee seeds and can hatch in the warehouse. So all in all, pretty gross. There are a bunch of other insects that occasionally impact coffee, such as ants, cicadas, grasshoppers, and even termites. And of course, depending on the level of infestation, they can be really damaging. To summarize the coffee pests mini seminar, what's important to know is that coffee pests are challenging to manage. Often you have to physically remove them in order to manage them, which means working with traps or just physical labor to remove them. And they affect plant health either directly, such as the case with the twig borers or stem borers, and they can be really, really impactful to productivity and really a whole plantation. Other times, a bug can work indirectly to impact quality, like Entestia. In any case where a bug is impacting a plant, you have the potential to impact yield, but also the potential to impact quality, because when a plant is hit by a bug, it is no longer in its optimal state of health. And therefore, you just don't have the same potential for quality that you do with a healthy plant. That concludes our mini seminar on coffee pests. If you'd like to learn more about CQI, our mission, and education, please visit our website.